Slepen.
Fuck, stupid old fucking white mages. Bloody hell. Black mages. Bloody hell.
Did you have to fight him?
Yes. Piece of shit. Things are better than us just because they're with more than us. Maybe I just cause another epidemic again. See how they feel about it. Piece of shit.
How much alcohol have you drunk in the last 4 hours?
Idols count. Doesn't matter because it's their fucking fault. I swear to God, if I see one more black mage today, I will end this world. The ancients were right.
Why do smart ones always batshit insane?
Maybe because when you get to a level of intelligence, you realize how messed up this world is.
No, I think it's just a you problem.
I doubt that.
God damn it. Goddamn clock. Why is it hanging so low?
Because I don't see you otherwise. You know what? You can sit there in that one. There's much space for you.
Yeah, you can see this is made for an Abu Ra.
Yes, it is. Anyways, I don't have a bed for you that probably fits, but you can stay over there for a while.
Well, thank you.
The only times I kick you out is when my wife comes.
I don't want to be here when she comes.
But now then. I ask you one more time, are you sure about this?
I'll tell you again, there is very little I have left to lose.
Alright then, I want you to spill all the secrets about your place.
What do you want to know first?
Let's start with the history.
I'll start with the other clan first, the Sea Wolves.
You want to start with the general information? Fine.
General information there, really. I'm not sure how much of it would be interesting to you.
Well, I am interested, otherwise I wouldn't ask. Don't get sassy with me, Charles.
You can trace our lineage back to the bleak isles of the Northern Empty. Our name's actually reference that. Vugadin means the people of the rain.
Interesting.
Our ancestral home, Eersland, or the first land in the old Vugadin tongue. Most of us fled about, 7 centuries ago? After a tyrant rose up, and we didn't want to deal with that. A large part of us, we landed on the Veilbrand, the Isle of Limsa Lominsa, which soon rose to prosperity.
Oh, thanks to you guys or something else?
I honestly don't know. I haven't spent enough time in Eorzea to really
very honorable of you to say so, honest. But you don't talk about it as if you were the cause without certainty. It's a good quality to have. So continue.
Well, there's also an entirely different group that crossed the continent onto Kerabania and the volcanoes that were there. These eventually became known as the Hellsguard, which is my clan.
Oh, I see. I'll be honest, I have no experience with Rogadin, except for seeing them as pirates. I frankly haven't traveled to recently I have. Maybe you know this race, the Rothgar.
Rothgar, yes, I know of them.
Of the what?
I know of the Rothgar, yes.
I see. Interesting. I might ask you about it later. I might be old and intelligible, but I don't know everything. So, about your clans, tell me more about them. Start in a nice generalization.
Well, there are the two largest clans are really the two only ones. The sea wolves who are mostly settled in Limsa Lominsa, and the Hellsguard who are settled in the mountains and volcanoes near Gerapania. You also have those who don't belong to any clan. They've mostly settled in the Ilsebaard and the far eastern continent of Ozard.
And do those look different to you guys, or?
That depends. The Ilsebaardian Bruganin, they mostly look the same as any sea wolf or Hellsguard, but the Ozardians, they're different. They look more like oversized hewers. They have lighter skin tones and they don't have the flat nose that most Rubenin have.
I see. That is very interesting. Now, when you say you come from there, does this mean you're under guardian control?
Oh well, I was not actually born in Ilsebaard. I'm a guard, but well, how they work? They're not a large clan. Mostly in the volcanic areas, there's not much to support us. So usually, what happens? The second, the third, fourth, however many children you have, only really the first can stay and live in the villages. The rest are usually sent off for it to make their own fate somewhere.
That is harsh, but a harsh reality of truth, I suppose, and conditions.
Yes. I think I was about 15, 16 when I was forced to leave our village. That's about 75 years ago now. Damn.
Interesting. So, what about the identity of your people?
Well,
I know from experience Rogadin value strength, and not only physically but mentally, if it's correct.
Yes, any kind of strength, physical, magical, even the strength of will. It doesn't really race, identity, nothing of that matters as long as you can prove that you are strong.
So, in that regard, even a small Lalafell or a female Rain or Seda could win the trust or respect from one of the mightiest Rogadin simply by showcasing their word?
Exactly.
It sounds like a very, how to put this, merit-like system, a meritocracy, if it serves me correct.
Meritocracy, yes, but there's also the downside of it. If you can't prove your strength, then well, most Rugenin won't even give you the time of day, let alone help or defend you in any way.
Interesting. This is very interesting. So would coin help in that matter? I would say that many Rugenin will be insulted with that, or is that not the case?
Well, that really depends on their occupation. As you probably know, a lot of Rugadins are sellswords, mercenaries, so they would definitely accept the coin no matter who it comes from, weak or strong. But
will they, how to put it, not do as much effort in it if they don't respect you? That's my question.
Most likely that's at least the experience I have had with most people. As well, as you so quickly saw through it, my facade, I don't really put a lot of stock in the whole meritocracy business.
I see. Well then, let's get over onto the seawolves, as you put it. What are they like?
Well, they're descending from the seafaring people of the north. there. Most of them are settled in Limsa Lomins and have made their and have made make a living as mercenary sellsword pirates, or and a lot of them have also joined the Maelstrom.
It is intriguing. And what is their physical qualities?
Well, as you can see, all Vuganin, even the females, are extremely muscular and tall. Most of their muscle is focused on our arms, legs, and necks mostly.
I can clearly see that my entire body fits in your entire arm.
Yes, it's also a piece of our culture. You see this armor. These are specifically made to showcase mostly our muscles in our arms and in our backs, as you can see.
That is interesting. Yeah, it makes them stand out, I suppose.
It's more connected to the meritocracy of if you can show your muscles, then the chance that they see you as strong greatly increases.
Interesting. Okay. And this goes for both the Sea Wolves and the Hellsguard.
Yes, although Hellsguard are a bit less about it's less about showing their strength and more just about pure practicality. Well, living in a volcanic area is hard.
Understandable. So, what about the naming structure and system of the Sea Wolves?
The Sea Wolves, their naming structure is mostly based on the old Vuganin languages. We don't really have much of a picture left of what it completely looks like. Mostly we just know a few words and sentences, and that's about it. So the language is constantly evolving from old tomes we find. Mostly the... for example, we'll usually have two... Our first names are comprised of two words. I, for example, Eiri and Selb. Eiri means wandering, Selb means sage. So I would be the wandering sage. And yes, before you ask, I gave that name to myself.
I didn't want to intrude, but that's actually how to put this. That is kind of cute.
Most people wouldn't dare to call me cute, usually, after the facade has fallen, at least. Anyway, onto our surnames. Our surnames are a lot easier. I don't actually follow the normal naming conventions of surnames. Normally it goes the name of the father, usually, is the first part of the surname. And then just son, daughter, woman, whatever the hell else you want after that. Just something to show what you are.
Basically, your names turn into sentences.
Basically, for example.
Interesting. So, yeah, what is the culture of these Sea Wolves then?
Well, they're also more focused on practicality as a seafaring folk. Just fish and food, just simple seasonings were usually nothing. A lot of salt, so it doesn't start rotting when you're on the sea. And right. Also a lot of ale and wine. I think you might like them for that.
Oh yeah, I can definitely see enjoying that. So let's get on to your clan.
The Hellsguard. Well, what do you want? What would you like to know first?
Well, let's start with the physical appearances.
Physical appearances. Most of the Hellsguard have a more red, brownish tinted skin, usually from years of the exposure of heat and the generations that lived there before.
So you're kind of an odd case then.
Well, kind of. Although I don't know how much of that is simply the genetics of my family line, or just that I've spent what last 75 years away from the village.
Hmm.
So I do remember a few memorable moments in my childhood, which are old tradition of which include our old traditions of fire walking, since
everything back.
Yes, you take some hot coals and just you have to walk over them for a long, long time so you can get the soles of your feet more acclimated to the boiling rock of the volcanoes of Kiribania. They're painful memories, but they helped back then.
So now is my question. There is this rumor about it giving mystical powers. That sounds like geomancy to me.
How exactly do you mean? Do you mean how the Hell's Guard are more capable of magic, or?
It's like I read this transcript once that firewalking is not only training for young age, but it brings out their latent mystical talents.
Ah, yes, that.
That sounds an awful lot like geomancy.
Something about the culture of the Hell's Guard themselves. We, the Hell's Guard, believe that volcanoes are a door to, well, the afterlife, basically. And that our ancestors settled there as a means to keep the gate closed so spirits couldn't get out.
Right.
I've never been entirely certain if the firewalking ritual actually helped with the mystic power. It certainly didn't do anything for me, at least.
So, what is the naming system for your clan?
The Hell's Guard use more of the common tongue. Mostly just names like Tall Mountain or Blue Lily. It's all based on the natural world. We don't really use the old language anymore.
And most
of us don't even have surnames. It just, if you're fiercely individual, and most people think that a surname, well, it takes that away.
That's very interesting. So, you talked about the vegetation being scarce in your homeland, which is very understandable. What other parts of this of the culture is affected by this?
Well, you do not let anything go to waste. If it can be eaten, it will be eaten. And, well, we don't really have any interest in the culinary arts, the delicacies. Just as long as it can be eaten, we'll use it to survive.
Well, I think I understand enough now. How about this? I'll take Yuen as my pupil. But you will have to learn everything about magic.
Define everything. Every school, thaumaturgy, arcanism.
No. Aetherial magic. We're not going to discuss void magic.
Really?
After all, that is not my expertise. Let's start with geomancy, shall we? It should bring you to a more understanding of the healing arts. Come with me to my class.
Goddamn clock.